Hey, Out Late But Great, this is Jim here from Ohio, and it is Friday, and I am your host on Fridays on the channel Out Late But Great. So anyway, guys, Sydney picked the topic of the week, and it was submitted by a viewer, and I'm going to read it to you because it's kind of long. One of the rites of passage for teenage straight guys is running the gauntlet of the third degree known as meeting the dad of the girl he's dating and submitting to a barrage of questions on topics ending in the cold, hard stare. And you will respect my daughter guilt trip, fear of doing anything inappropriate. As same-sex dating becomes more accepted, how do you feel that scenario is going to play out in the future? Well, guys, I can usually talk about anything, but I have thought about this all week long, and I am just clueless. I really am. Because I don't have any kids, and as I've told you before, I did not date much in high school at all. Because I knew I was gay when I was a little kid, and I just never had the desire to. I didn't have the attraction to date girls, because I knew I was gay, even though I was just a little kid. So, I mean, I did a little bit, but I never ran into anything like that. This reminds me of something like from an old 1950s TV show, like Ozzie and Harriet, where the father is sitting in a leather couch smoking a pipe with his tie and white shirt on, and the boyfriend comes and is being interviewed or something. I really don't think that happens in our society today. I really don't. And I can't really connect as far as my own life, because I did not come out till I was 30, so I was a man with my own home, and so I never, you know, my parents, my dad was dead, and my mom, you know, when I took Dave over to meet her, and she liked him and loved him. You know, my Aunt Ruth, I really do think my Aunt Ruth, who she died when she was like in her 90s, I think she liked him better than she liked me. So I never had to run into that. And as far as his family goes, his mom has always been nice. I mean, she was kind of weird at first when he came out to her and they didn't speak for a while, but I mean, ever since then, I mean, she's been fine. So, you know, it's all been good. So, yeah, I'm really stuck on this one. I really am. Jim from Atlanta brought up a good point, though, that a lot of people, you know, when they have kids that are lesbian and gay, that they let their boyfriends and girlfriends stay over, and because they don't have to worry about them getting pregnant. But, you know, I thought, well, gee, you know, what about STDs and HIV? You know, you still have to think about that too. So it'll be interesting now to see how the whole thing plays out with same-sex parents, because you know, that's a whole different ball of wax. The same-sex parents that I know are awesome. They really are. Of course, you know, I'm friends with Jay and Brian LeFou, and they are the best dads in the whole world. You know, Zach Walls, his parents are awesome. I mean, look what they have done. Look what they have created. I mean, this kid is brilliant, and I'm sure he's going to go far. I did meet another same-sex couple this past fall in New York, and you know, they have a little boy now, and they actually hired a surrogate to have another baby, which is going to be coming here pretty soon. But I mean, you can just tell, you know, that I'm friends with them on Facebook, and they love their kids. So it's really going to be fun to sit back and watch the show. So anyway, guys, this probably isn't a very long video, but I just can't think of anything else to say. So it's supposed to be really nice here this weekend, so we're just going to hang outside and enjoy the sunshine. So anyway, guys, that's all I got to say. Take care, love you, and I will talk to you next week. Bye-bye.